So here I am going to channel an answer to my question about what I'm going through right now, which pertains to opening a business. My ego's resistance to it, which I feel throughout the day and whenever I am talking about the business or thinking about the business or this new role that I will play in society. So I would like a higher self answer describing what my ego's why my ego's resistance is there, and what I can do to dissipate and remove that resistance, because I know that what I am doing is part of my soul's path and part of my service here during this lifetime, and I would like my resistance to it to leave if that is what is most appropriate. Lincoln, what you have done, you have prepared for throughout many lifetimes here on planet Earth. This is a lifetime of service, one of helping humanity through this great time of energetic change, a change in their consciousness so radical they will not recognize who they will become. It will be for the better, it will be for the best of all life involved everywhere. The planetary alignments will change the outcome of consciousness on this planet once and for all, no longer returning to the throes of death and destruction in its grossest material form. Yes, there still may be disarguments and resolution between family members. However, it will not be the way it has been in the past, where violence has run rampant over your countrysides, destroying all in its path. The earth has been treated with disrespect and disregard as you forward yourself in the name of progress. This will no longer happen because you will find the connection to the true source within you, no longer seeking sustenance in the limited forms around you, but when I can recognize them for what they are, being limited creations for your enjoyment and pleasure, and ultimately your respect and love. They will not be used to reach short ends of greed and conquering over other men. As for you, Lincoln, you have resistance to your path because you yourself have been persecuted in past lifetimes by family and friends, by government agencies, and by social groups for your outlandish behavior, because it goes so much against the norm. People believe they are not connected and don't want you to be connected either. They want you to join in their suffering so you can find a commonality with them, one that serves to uplift their egoic image of who the world is and who they themselves are in it. You, Lincoln, you must walk through this resistance. No one will be here to help you, only yourself, for it is a path that you must walk alone at this time. We have not deserted you, and you are never truly alone, but this is a decision you must make on your own, and a power you must muster up inside yourself to walk through the resistance that exists deep inside your core. Yes, life has been brutal and violent at times for you, and we have great compassion for what you have walked through and what you will walk through in this lifetime, but it is necessary that you muster your strength and walk through this process at this time. Have no fear, have trust in God, and have trust in the higher order of the divine things all around you. Trust yourself, trust your connection, and walk forward, my son. For you yourself are the only one that can make this decision. You must walk in the shoes of the Christ at this time, bestowing limitless blessings upon all of mankind, no longer discerning who deserves what. You must share yourself equally with all and forever with all. They are all your children. You are their children too. We are all children of the one divine creator. We are pure expressions of love. We must remember that always, and we must share that always with all of life everywhere. Now, Lincoln, there's not much we can say to do about how you must walk through this. This is an answer you will find within yourself. Find that strength within yourself, that strength to be who you are, to know who you are, and to find the love within yourself. When you find and fully connect to the love within yourself, you will not be seeking it in life forms around you. That is a limited form of love, a conditional form of love, not based in the love of the true supreme source, the one God that is within all, that is creating all, and that is above and beyond all. We must find that love within our hearts, and then we will see that love within all of life everywhere. The love is one and the same. It was created from the very beginning, when the first form appeared, even before the Adams and the Eves of your biblical story. Now you, Lincoln, you must find that strength within yourself. You must surrender to your path. When the ego rises up within you, you must let it fall away, recognizing it for what it is, a false idea of who you are, a false perception based on this lifetime and past lifetimes of cultural conditioning that have only served to limit your true being, your true nature, yet which a flame that you have kept burning deep inside of you all along. You have preserved this flame up until this moment in time so that you can do your service, so that you can walk your path into greater glory, glory for God in the highest, and peace to his people on earth. For that is what is within your heart, peace and love and happiness for all of mankind. Peace and love and happiness over the entire planet with no more suffering, no more struggle, no more bloodshed, no more fear, and no more chaos. The planet will be restored to natural order with your help and with the help of light workers all around you. As you resonate with your full potential self, these other beings will be attracted to you and life will flow effortlessly in the joyous splendor that it was designed to be from the very beginning. You will uplift mankind as you uplift yourself. This is how all of humanity works, especially at this time of universal empowerment. The energy coming into your planet is tenfold stronger than it's ever been. You have the opportunity to grow quicker and faster and fuller than it's ever been presented before on this planet in your soul's incarnations. You must choose to take advantage of this time, for it will not come around again. This is a period of great transition, one where you will go from night into day, one you will see the darkness fade before your very eyes. Wouldn't you like to be walking the path with humanity as they grow and as they mature into greater and greater divine godhood? Yes, that is what we would like for all of us to see. For that is the divine plan, to return to peace and love and harmony. The time of violence and pestilence is over. We must surrender to our true nature, we must walk forward in strength and courage, and when the egoic limitations rear their ugly head, let them pass, for they are not who you are. Do not fight them, do not judge them, do not hold them in front to examine them, for that just keeps them going. It keeps them in your consciousness and it provides life force energy to the egoic limitations of this divine pure self that you truly are. You are consciousness, unlimited and unbound by physical manifestations and form. You can travel through the universe at will, full body, full consciousness, dissolve and reappear in any dimensions that you so choose. You can do the works of Jesus Christ. All can do the works of Jesus Christ and greater. The potential that you have with the new energies moving onto this planet provide a greater opportunity for growth and a greater opportunity of manifestation of the divine glories of your infinite power than Jesus ever had during his lifetime. He came into a time of darkness, mired with violence and hate and fear and lust and greed and sloth. All of these. You yourself are in a time where humanity is moving through them. This was not so in the case of Jesus. Jesus had to move through during a time when humanity was stuck in the mire and could not see the light. He walked into the darkest of ages and enlightened it for all of mankind, preparing the way for you and your friends and your children to walk through. The light that will heal this earth, that will heal humanity and bring it back into a divine order. Behavior in harmony with life, be in harmony with nature, in harmony with your divine God self. Let spirit manifest before you. See this earth realm as a spirit incarnate, not as matter and density and limitation. You are spiritual beings, unbound by form,